Pivot tables are great, but they kind of limit us to a few different functions or different ways of summarizing data, like sum, average, a lot of the typical things. But a lot of times we want other values, like median is a great example, where pivot tables don't allow us to aggregate data by the median. But there are some tricks that we can do that allow us to give us this median value in a pivot table.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the Engineering Toolbox Channel, where I give you the tools you need to solve real-world engineering problems.
So in order to help us understand how to get the median value in a pivot table, I've come up with an example. And this is a bunch of production data basically that I created. We have the job, the part number, the completion date of the job, the quantity of the part completed, the number of hours it took, and then the hours per part, which is a calculated value, basically dividing those out. And we want to aggregate or summarize this data by the part numbers. So we could just take our table here and go to insert, add a pivot table, and let's say we add part numbers to row and the hours per part, and let's do an average of that. And we can see that there is only sum, count, max, min, product, count number, standard deviation, but there's no median value here. We can't aggregate by the median. So let's just add an average in there just for a baseline, and that's pretty typical. But like I said, pivot tables don't allow us to add that median in there. So in order to do that, we have to get a little bit creative. So we're going to add a median column here, and we're actually going to aggregate the median right within our table. So we're going to create a function here, and it's going to be median, and then we're going to make it an if function. And this is going to be an array function, which can get a little tricky, but I'm going to try to break it down for you. And we're going to say if the part numbers, so all the part numbers, if any one of those equals this part number, then we're going to look to the hours per part values array here. And then we'll close that off, and then close that off again. And then because it's an array function, we're going to hit Control and Shift, hold those, and then hit Enter. And these are going to be our median values for each part number. Let me try to explain this a little more because it's kind of confusing. So what this is saying is it's going to look at each part number in our array here, and if it equals the part number in this specific row, then it's going to look to the matching hours per part value of that row and feed it to the median function. So it's basically saying every part with this number, we're going to look at each value for the hours per part and then take the median of those values. I know it's kind of confusing, but it does work. So now we have a median value for each part number in our table. So then we will go back to our pivot table and drop in our median value, and then we're going to actually average those. So that'll basically take the average of each value for the part number. It's the same value, but it gives us the median value then for each specific part number. And just to confirm this, let's go ahead and look at one specific part number. So if I just pick one here, I'll pull all of these values back over to this sheet, just paste them there, and then let's look at the median function of all those, and you can see that these values match them.
All right, I hope you all enjoyed that one. To get more videos as they are released, make sure to hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, make sure to like and share, and if you didn't like it, well, then leave me a comment and let me know how I can improve. Last but not least, this channel is for you, so if you have any suggestions for topics you want me to cover, make sure to let me know. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.